What's up, everybody? Well, I wanted to go a little more in depth with the BIOS 320 on the ASUS G15 Advantage. So I decided I would run three games real quick. Forza Horizon, Cyberpunk 2077, and Shadow of the Tomb Raider. So we'll just go in order of easiest to run. We'll do Forza first, then Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and then we'll move into Cyberpunk. So, and then we'll downgrade back to 316, run their benchmarks and whatnot, and maybe get a little bit of gameplay in too, and just see if it's any better. I'll decide once I get in there if we're going to get any extra gameplay. Might be best to just stick with the benchmarks, because they're easy to just look back at the video and be like, okay, yep, nope, that improved. Oh no, that did not improve. So on and so forth. It's way harder to do that with just actual footage. Unless you literally run in the exact same spot every time, and even then, time of day changes, and that's just too much. So let's just go with the benchmarks, guys. This will be a pretty short video, but that's okay. So, why don't we get into Forza, look at the settings we're gonna run, and then run that benchmark. Well, all right, after seeing how the 3D Mark tests ran, I figured I would run some games too, so I figured we'll do a part two here for the BIOS 320, and I figured we'd start with Forza Horizon 5. And we're just going to do the suggested preset, which is Ultra. So here's what all that entails here. Scroll through real quick. And then we're just going to run the benchmarks for these games. We're not going to bother getting gameplay. That's too hard to compare to what we got before. So now, let's go back up here and run the benchmark. All right. So here's how the results play out. All of our video memory, system memory, model, and all that. Suggested preset, which we are on. Here's our FPS average and whatnot, and the minimum, and the maximum, and our performance summary up here, benchmark graph. We got 103, we got 7 stutters, and 89% GPU lumage, and 28% latency. So now, why don't we go ahead and move on to the next game. Now for a little Shadow of the Tomb Raider. We're going to play on DirectX 12 mode, 1440p. Full screen, the correct GPU, of course. All right, no VSync, because that get in the way. And we've also got SMAATX on, or 2X2 on. And then here's all of our other settings, pretty much on Ultra, besides having ray tracing on. So now, why don't we go run that benchmark? All right, so here's all the settings we ran, or at least some of them, not all of them. Here's frames rendered. We averaged 79. There's the rest of the info right here. And all right, now let's go move on to Cyberpunk. Now we're gonna run Cyberpunk, so let's just go through on the settings. I am running ultra quality, super resolution. That gives me playable FPS in this game. Otherwise, I gotta tone the settings down way too far, even without ray tracing. It's a really hard game to run. All right, no ray tracing though. So, why don't we go run the benchmark? Well, all right, we got 77.68 for average, 50.25 for minimum, and 113.74 for max. There's a number of frames and everything, and all the settings. Well, it's not all of them, but some of them. And all right, now let's go put the old 316 back on this thing and see how it does. Well, now we're back on BIOS 316, so we're gonna run Forza Horizon 5 again at the exact same settings as it was before. So now let's back out of here. We'll look at the graphics. Again, we're on the preset Ultra. So it's all the same settings as it was before, but just so you can see, no funny business. All right, now let's just scroll back on up. And then let's run this benchmark. Well, all right, benchmark's all finished here on 316. And the game version, all this should be the same. Ultra preset and all that good stuff. There's our little performance summary and FPS averages and all of that good stuff. And we got 10 stutters this time versus 7, but we got 3 extra FPS on average. And we got a little bit better latency, I believe, or relatively the same. Now on to Shadow of the Tomb Raider again. Same settings as before, DirectX 12, 1440p. We're on the right GPU, SMAAT2X, and aliasing. And here's all the other settings on Ultra, except for having ray trace shadows on. That just kills FPS on this thing. So now it's time to get into the benchmark. All right, the benchmark's all done on 316 now. Here's all the settings, well, at least some of them.
We got 13,000 frames rendered. We got 84 this time, so that is, I believe, let's see, we got 79 before, so that's quite the increase. That's 5 extra FPS. That's definitely not just random, you know? Anyway, though, why don't we go ahead and move on? Last up, we got some Cyberpunk 2077 on the same settings as before. All we've changed is the BIOS. We've gone back to 316. So we'll just scroll all the way to the bottom, and then we'll run that benchmark. And there we go. No ray tracing either, just like before. So now it's benchmark time. All right, we got 79 FPS, average, 50 minimum, and 118 max. I believe we got 77 average before and only 113 max. So we definitely did better in this game on 316 as well, by more than just a reasonable error anyway.
Well, all right, guys. So we've come to the conclusion, and even though some of the benchmarks claimed 320 was a little faster, all the games had like 3 to 4 FPS higher on average, and that's too close or too much of an FPS difference to be just like a possibility of error. You know, if it was only one, I'd, you know, be like, okay, they're pretty similar. There's not much difference. But all of them were 3 to 4 FPS more on average, and a lot of them had higher maxes too. So I am going to say the conclusion is 316 is still the way to go for the Asus G15 Advantage. Now, come on, Asus. In 320, give us all the improvements that might be happening in the background of the other ones that I didn't run, like in 320. And in 321, give us all that, plus let us max out our fan. Unless there's a legitimate reason why they slowed them down other than just noise. But I've been running these like max speed for like a year, and they're not rattling, they're not doing anything weird whatsoever. So I don't think that's the case. I think they're just trying to quiet it down, and I would rather have all the performance. That's just me. But you guys can make your call if you care about the 3-4 performance loss and you'd rather just have a quieter laptop and you want whatever improvements may or may not be in the background, then go to 320. But if you're like me and you want max performance without them telling you what you can and can't do with the RPMs of the fans and just taking away 1,000 RPM, then stay on 316 like me. But that's about it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And until the next one, peace out, guys.